With the stroke of a pen, the federal government has undone Victoria's Belt and Road Agreement with China, declaring it not consistent with our nation's foreign policy. It's prompted an angry reaction from Beijing, which has branded the move provocative and unreasonable. State political reporter Andrew Lund.
Signed by the Premier in 2018 and 2019, the Belt and Road Agreements were supposed to put Victoria in the box seat for business with Beijing.
There's great opportunities for Victorian firms to really have the inside running.
But it put the state on a collision course with Canberra, and last night the federal government called stop.
They are not consistent with Australia's approach to foreign policy, and under the legislation will be terminated.
China was quick to express its strong displeasure and resolute opposition to the announcement, which it described as an unreasonable and provocative move that is bound to bring further damage to bilateral relations.
I just think it's bizarre to hear the Chinese embassy complaining about provocation when they are out doing it daily.
The Andrews government appears to have accepted the decision, but left it to Small Business Minister Jala Pulford to duck questions on whether it overstepped its mark.
Were you dabbling in foreign policy by signing up to the BRI?
I don't dabble in foreign policy.
Was it the state government dabbling in foreign policy?
Oh, look, I would refer to the federal government to talk about matters of foreign policy.
Viewed by some as economic imperialism, the Belt and Road Initiative uses billions of dollars of infrastructure investment to extend Chinese influence around the globe. And some trade experts say Victoria made the right move signing up.
Belt and Road Initiative is a global phenomenon, and it's a game changer. And it is vital for the Victorian government to participate in it in some ways.
But others argue the Belt and Road was a one-way street.
This should not be seen as being an anti-China move. This is a question of a bad, lopsided deal.
The state's largest trading partner may not see it that way.
Live to Andrew Lund at Treasury Place now. Andrew, what impact will this have on the state's economy?
Well, Pete, it's still unclear what, if any, impact this decision will have on Victorian business. But given the Belt and Road Agreements, we're in a relatively early stages. It's very likely that the short-term impact, at least, will be negligible. The more immediate risk is that China will impose more sanctions on Australian exports in retaliation. But that will be Canberra's problem, Pete.
Andrew Lund reporting.